लोक राहायचे, ज्या काळात पूजा अर्चा करायची, ही संपूर्ण रेसिडेन्शियल इथे टाउनशिप होत. नेक्स्ट, दीज आर दी क्लोजअप्स ऑफ दी सेम स्कल्पचर्स. हे जे दान करणारे लोक आहेत, पीपल हू हॅव डोनेटेड फॉर दी एक्सकॅव्हेशन ऑफ दी केव्स, हू हॅव डोनेटेड फॉर दी एज्युकेशन, हू हॅव डोनेटेड फॉर दी रिलीजन, देअर इमेजेस आर कार्व्ड देयर. अँड अर्लियर इट वॉज अ सिस्टम. द सिस्टम वॉज दॅट when you are donating something, your name is appearing there or your sculpture is appearing there. To give you one more example, we have the famous World Heritage Site of Sanchi. Sanchi's stupa, we are knowing about them. The ancient stupas of Sanchi, the traders of this region of Aurangabad, they have given the donations. Pokardhan is a place near Sillod. To the traders of Pokardhan, and they were not the ordinary traders, they were the ivory traders. Hastinandache, he vyapari hoti. Tenni Sanchicha akha stupa sathi dengi dili asa Sanchicha stupa madhe ullekh aahe. There is a rock cut inscriptions. The traders of Bhogavardhana of that time, they have given this donation. So there is a system. Whenever you give a donation, today we get a receipt. Or we don't know, like we, when we go to some temple, people just donate white and black and everything. As upon Pasha, that's a book not as a mother, yes, right? It can. But yeah, unaccounted. When Buddhism was there, then he unaccounted Salatna. Yeah, it can name it. Upon Paisa, Dari Dila, Dhan Dari Dila, that there's a kind of thing in the Puravas. So this is that. Next, please. Again, one more evidence. Of the donations. Next. Here again you can see there are several people shown on the sculptures. We don't concentrate on the Buddha. We concentrate on the others. Either Shilpa Kai Santai, these are the people. These are the followers. Next. Now we are comparing Ajanta with Aurangabad, Rajtaalaka. The left sculpture is from cave number 4 of Aurangabad caves, Rajtaalaka caves. He just navigated this day, Kutla, Aurangabad. Ujvi Kutla, 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 Ajanta. He is a Chaitya Guru. Unfortunately, the Chaitya Gurus of Aurangabad caves, they have come down. We have only some remains. And Chaitya Guru is always known as the place of worship. In Buddhist architecture, we have two. The Chaityas and the Viharas. Viharas is the place for resting, taking rest. Or it is a gathering where people can, it is like a hall where you can conduct some event. Then you can conduct a class. It might be a classroom. They have the residential cells where they can stay. And Chaitya Guru, the image of the Buddha is there, or some objects are there which are revered, in which we have some rituals. So these two types of architecture are formed in Buddhist cave architecture. Here we find the Chaitya architecture. Next. Now this is one of the very important sculptures of this Rajtaalaka caves, that is known as the dancing panel. Like Venerable Chowmen was there in Ajanta, and you might have seen the most famous Padmapani at Ajanta, Vajrapani, the paintings. But again, one more important painting is there, that is about the dancing girl of Ajanta. It is world famous. That is in painting. And this, it is in the sculpture. Here what you can see, what is the interpretation of the sculpture? For us, laymen, common men, आपल्याला काय दिसलं तिथे? एक स्त्री डान्स करते, तिच्या आजूबाजूला 5-6 अजून आहेत स्त्रिया, ते काहीतरी वाद्य वाजवतात. याचा अर्थ काय? याचा अर्थ काय? इंटरप्रिटेशन काय? की 2000 इयर्स अगो इन दी केव्ह ऑफ राजताळका दिस आर्ट वॉज ऑल्सो टॉट. भारतीय शास्त्रीय संगीत कुठले प्रकार असतात त्याच्यात? जे काही प्रकार असतात त्याच्यात तुम्हाला हा प्रकार कोणी सांगितला का? ओरिजिन कुठे आहे त्याच? इथे आहे. यू कॅन सी दी वुमेन इन द सेंटर, शी इज इन अ त्रिभंगा पोज. हे तुम्हाला नॉर्मली कथ्थक मध्ये भरतनाट्यम मध्ये दिसतं. ही शास्त्रीय नृत्याची सुरुवात कुठे झाली? तुम्हाला अभ्यास करायचा आहे, यू शुड गो टू द केव्स. यू गो टू औरंगाबाद, अजंता, एलोरा, पित्तलकोरा, एव्हरी वेअर यू विल फाइंड दिस. सो दिस पर्टिक्युलर आर्ट फॉर्म ऑफ डान्स, क्लासिकल डान्स, युजली वी कॉल इंडियन क्लासिकल डान्स, इट इज द ओरिजिन इज इन द केव्स. दिस वॉज ऑल्सो टॉक लाइक यस्टरडे व्हेन वी मेट वेनरेबल चेयरमैन. सो शी वॉज टेलिंग अस दैट इन हर टेम्पल they also train the students in dance. So I got the link that it is not only in Taiwan or in China or in South Asia, this origin is in the caves. Since that time it is going on. And when you see the other women, other figures are there. One is playing the flute, somebody is playing the dholki, or somebody is playing the tabla. So these are all musical instruments, vocal and all. So this was also there. Ya apnala kay vatla pura. So this kind of education, now I am not concentrating on that religion. Moreover, I am concentrating on what was going on in the caves. Caves madhe mhanje lehni madhe kay chalayche. Hi sagle apnala shikshanache prakar. These are the several forms of education. Like today we have 42 departments in our university. We have physics, we have chemistry, we have so many departments. We have Pali, Buddhism, Sanskrit. So everything was there. Departments were there. And they are teaching different forms, different disciplines. So it is a well-established fact that the caves, not only the Rashtalka caves or Ajanta caves or Ellora caves, all caves of ancient India, they were the institutes of higher learning. And fortunately, we are in the same campus. We are having the same caves. Next, please. So here we find that the period of the Aurangabad Rajtalka caves, it is 2000 years. During the 8th century AD, we find that there is the decline of Buddhism in ancient India and there is a revival of Hinduism. Decline and revival of Hinduism. So when Hinduism was revived, that time something's changed in the Buddhist philosophy, Buddhist religion as such. What was the change? Like usually in India we follow Mahayana. We have Theravada, we have different forms. But we have very important form, that is the Vajrayana. And Aurangabad or Rajtalka caves is the only cave in the world which is having this sculptures from Vajrayana faith. If you want to know more about Vajrayana, you have to come to Aurangabad. So these are some of the sculptures from the Vajrayana faith. Please go on. Next. These are from the eastern side. Now this is the very famous sculpture for Aurangabad. On the east caves, cave number 6, that is the Ashtavaya. 8 fears they are depicted there. Next. Again, this is one of the gatekeepers, we call him Vajrapani. Next. And this is the view of the Aurangabad caves in the university campus. It is during the monsoon season, we have this beautiful waterfall. So, friends, we will stop here because we have to hear Venerable Chairman. And this was just a small attempt to show you that the caves are not merely the Buddhist caves, but these are the caves of higher education, centers of higher learning. And we are still imparting the same education. I will give you two more examples, or I will rather give you one example. This year, we are celebrating the 125th birth anniversary of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. There is a place in Japan known as Koyasan. In Koyasan, we have established the statue of Dr. Ambedkar. The Honorable Chief Minister of Maharashtra, he was there for the inauguration. Our Honorable Vice Chancellor was also there. And several leaders, Buddhist leaders and the state leaders, even Kaikwad sir was there for the inauguration. They went to the ancient University of Koyasan and they came back. But it was decided by the government of Maharashtra and the government of Wakayama prefecture. The CM has declared that we will be celebrating the 125th birth anniversary in Koyasan University. And I was invited there as the official guest for this event. I was the chief guest and the speaker. I gave a lecture on the life and achievements of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. For this event, the Honorable Minister for Tourism and Home, Mr. Ram Shinde, represented Maharashtra. And for India, representing India, the ambassador was there, Mr. Amit Kumar. And several dignitaries were there. I gave the lecture, I got the protocol. But that is another part. When I went there, I stayed there for 7 days. 4 days in Koyasan and 2 days in Tokyo. For 4 days, I was studying the environment, what is going on there. So when I took the information, I went and visited so many temples. So when Buddhism was going away from India, when it was on the decline in 8th century AD, आठव्या शतकामध्ये भारतातून बौद्ध धम्म लुप्त झाला त्या काळामध्ये ड्यूरिंग दॅट टाइम अ पर्सन फ्रॉम जपान नेम्ड एज कोबादायशी ही वेंट टू चायना ही ट्रॅव्हल टू चायना ही क्रॉस द सीज ही स्टेड देअर फॉर सेव्हरल इयर्स ही लर्न्ड बुद्धिझम अँड ही केम बॅक टू जपान अलॉंग विथ 2 shiploads of the books. He came back and he went to the emperor. And when he went to the emperor, he told that I have come with a new faith, a new philosophy, new religion. And I want to propagate it. I want to practice it. I want the people to follow this religion, this faith. So the emperor, he granted him some land. And that land was the mountains of Koyasan. It is like a lotus temple, the entire ranges. It has a very higher altitude. Nobody is permitted to go there. Only the Buddhists. And this particular Koyasan mountain, it is having the ancient University of Koyasan. Now today the university is 130 years old. So when I visited this university, madam was there. So I insisted on visiting the library. So they took us to the library. And when I was visiting the library, I was so surprised, I was so shocked that in this library, they are having 3,50,000 books. In which language? They are having these books in the Sanskrit language. They are having the books in the Pali, Prakrut, Sanskrit and Chinese. All handwritten. Hastalikhit. किती आहेत आपल्याकडे तिथे 3.5 लाख. आम्ही त्या लायब्ररी मध्ये गेलो, वी वेंट, वी विजिटेड द लायब्ररी, वी फाउंड दॅट दिस मच नंबर ऑफ बुक्स आर देयर. सो नोवेअर इन द वर्ल्ड वी हॅव दॅट मच बुक्स बिलॉंगिंग टू अ वन पर्टिक्युलर थिंग. सो दॅट इज कोयसान. फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आय वॉन्ट टू से द सेम थिंग. वेन वी टॉक अबाउट द केव्स, ancient centers of learning, we are having this university. It is also our duty as teachers and as students that we should go through the books. We should have a number of books. We should have a collection of books. Thousands and lakhs of books. Not only for the purpose of collection, but you should also read it. So with this, I will stop.